SST College of Arts and Commerce. You're watching SST Edupedia. I'm Professor Varsha Savlani. In this video, we are going to learn the basic introduction of human resource management. Now let's start. As human resource management is one of the core functional area of each and every business organization. Apart from that, there are the three other core functional areas of every business organization. One is marketing, finance, production, and HR. These are the four core functional areas of every business organization. So, in this clip, we are going to learn in detail about the one department which is called human resource management. Okay. So, human resource management is also called it as personal management. It's nothing but managing the people at workplace, which we called it as employees or workers. In this department, the each and every person is responsible to manage the people who are at workplace. So therefore, this department, HRM, is also called it as personal department. Let's look after the definition which are given by the few experts. Like, according to Carrie Dessler, he defines HRM is as a process, ek process hai, of acquiring, yani purchasing or hiring rather, training, appraising and compensating employees and attending to their labor relations, health and safety and fairness concern. What this expert says that HRM is a process. It's a process of hiring. We need to hire the right person at the right place at the right time. That's called acquiring with the help of recruitment and selection. Another one is training. While after completing the hiring process, we need to train the employees how to work, how to use the softwares, how to deal with the customers. Appraising, those who are working in a systematic manner, those who are working properly, the employees, those who are having the strength points, we need to appraise them. Now, appraisal may be a monetary, may be a non-monetary. And compensating employees, like monthly basis, they are getting the salaries as well as incentives, bonus. So, as per their performance, the compensating is being done by the company. Apart from the basic salary, the other incentives, the other allowances the companies are allotting. And attending to their labor relations. It's very much important that management need to keep a good relation with the laborers also, because they are also the very important part of the organization. And the company need to think about their health and safety measures. Like the workers, those who are working in contact to a machinery, they need to be given a fireproof jackets, hand gloves, gum boots, helmets, so that the company can be sure that they are securing the health and safety measures of the workers. As well as nowadays, the companies are giving the insurance also to the employees, not only to the employees but also their spouse or also their family members. And other fairness concerns like perks and other incentives. This is all about HRM. Means thinking about the employees, thinking for the people, those who are working in the organization, to achieve the objectives of the company. So, according to Carrie Dassler, HRM ek process hai. Process mein first kya hai? Acquiring, training, appraising, compensating. ये सारी चीज़ें, ये सारे फंक्शंस परफॉर्म किए जाते हैं बाय द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट. व्हाई? अटेंडिंग देयर लेबर रिलेशंस, हेल्थ एंड सेफ्टी मेजर्स एंड फेयरनेस कंसर्न. दिस इज व्हाट द वन एक्सपर्ट्स एक्सप्लेन द एचआरएम. लेट्स लुक आफ्टर व्हाट अदर एक्सपर्ट सेज. अकॉर्डिंग टू मैथिस एंड जैक्सन, एचआरएम डील्स विद द डिजाइन ऑफ फॉर्मल सिस्टम इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एक फॉर्मल सिस्टम बनाएंगे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में टू एंश्योर द इफेक्टिव एंड एफिशियंट यूज ऑफ ह्यूमन टैलेंट. द एम्प्लॉयज विच वी हैव, वी नीड टू एंश्योर दैट they work in an effective and efficient manner in our organization so that we can be able to achieve the set goals. हमने जो goals, हमने जो plans बनाए हैं company में वो हम लोग अच्छे से achieve कर पाए. That is the main reason we need to manage the people in an effective and efficient manner. That is what the human resource is. Now let's look after the features of HRM, or rather we can say characteristics of human resource management. Number one, HRM is an art and science. HRM is an art. Why? Because the people should be innovative. They should be creative at the workplace. They should every time come up with the new ideas, new concepts, so that the company can achieve easily their goals. And a science, एक process, एक system से हम लोग जाते हैं. Second is, HRM is pervasive. It is not just related to the business organization only. The HRM is also related to the hospitals, education, non-profit organizations. Everywhere we use this concept, it has a universal application. Human resource management has a universal application. Therefore, it is called it as HRM is pervasive. Third is, HRM is a process. As we saw in the definition, we need to acquire, we need to train, we need to motivate, we need to maintain, we need to retain the good employees in our organization. So it's a systematic process. Each and everything, one by one, we need to do with the employees. Not only we need to hire them, but we need to train them, we need to appraise them if they are working up to the mark, and we need to maintain them. Next, HRM is a continuous process. ऐसा नहीं है कि आज हमने हायर किया फिर बस दो साल बाद देखेंगे. नो, इट्स अ ऑनगोइंग प्रोसेस, इट्स अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस. एज वन ऑफ द की फंक्शन इज ऑल्सो दैट कंपेंसेटिंग एम्प्लॉइज. सो कंपनी एवरी मंथ नीड टू कंपेंसेट, एवरी टाइम दे नीड टू इवैल्यूएट देयर परफॉर्मेंस. एम्प्लॉइज का परफॉर्मेंस हर टाइम इवैल्यूएट किया जाता है. So HRM is a ongoing process. It's a continuous process. Next is, HRM is service function. No doubt, the HRM department itself perform the line function for their department. But for other departments called marketing, finance, production, they act as a staff function. Because if they required certain human resources, they need to ask the human resource department only. So HRM is a service function. It helps the other department to place the right person at the right position. Next, HRM must be regulation friendly. We need not to consider into a laws, rules, regulations, but it should be for the employees. Employees ke benefit ke liye hona chahiye. If say for example, if employees has a grievances, has a complaints, so they can easily come up to the HR department and put forth it. So it's a regulation friendly. Next, HRM is interdisciplinary and fast changing. As we know, every business is working in some or the other environment. There are the two environment, internal environment and external environment. So as the changes occurs in the environment, the HRM's policies also changes. It's interdisciplinary, means it is not just related to the one single business organization, it is related to different business organizations. Next, HRM is focused on results. The main aim is each and every individuals, those who are working in the organization as an employee. They may be individual, they are working in a team also. So individual goals as well as team goals need to be matched with the organizational goals. So HRM is completely related to the result oriented. It's focused. We need to achieve the organizational goals, where we need to focus on individual goals by giving them the development, career development of each and every employees. Next, HRM is people-centered, completely related to the employees, workers of the organization. Therefore, it is also called it as personal management, because in this we are managing the people. Human relations philosophy. HRM is related to the human relations. We need to maintain a good relation with each and every employee, with each and every workers. So HRM is completely related to the philosophy of the people, those who are working in the organization. Next, HRM is integrated concept. It is not isolation mein hum log nahi kaam kar sakte hain. It is integrated concept. As we have saw in the definition, first is acquiring, then training, then we need to give the appraisal, then we need to compensate, we need to promote, transfer. Ye sare integrated hain. Together we need to perform all those sub functions of the HR department. And last is HRM develops team spirit. Because nobody says that I am the one who is working in the company, because of me the company runs good, because of me we have achieved the profit. No one today in the organization works in isolation. Everybody works in a team. So HRM develops team spirit among the employees in the organization. So these all are the various characteristics, or we can say features, of human resource management. Let's look after the another why HRM is important in an organization. Kyun organization mein HRM department kafi zyada important hai? Okay, so the importance of HRM are nothing but attract and retain talent. अगर किसी कंपनी का एचआर पॉलिसीज बहुत अच्छा है, फेवरेबल है एम्प्लॉयज के साइड से, सो एम्प्लॉयज आर अट्रैक्टेड टू वर्क इन दैट कंपनी. टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ एनी एमएनसी कंपनी, टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ से फॉर एग्जांपल एसेंचर, आईबीएम, ये सारी कंपनीज है जहाँ पे एक फ्रेशर का विश होता है, काश मुझे इस कंपनी में जॉब मिले. क्यों? बिकॉज देयर एचआर पॉलिसीज आर वेरी गुड. They are thinking for the people. They are thinking for their employees. So HR policies should be that much good so that it attracts, not only attracts, but it retain the good employees. It retain the good talent. Second, train people for challenging roles. HRM is training on a continuous basis. Whatever the changes comes in the environment, accordingly, they are giving them the training. So the HRM gives that much training so that the employees can cope up, can overcome the challenging role in the organization. Third, develop skills and competencies. By giving the continuous training, by thinking about their career development, their human resource is able to develop the skills, polish the skills in a right path and competencies. Fourth one is promote team spirit. We need to promote the team spirit. The individuals, those who are working in the team, as a team, they need to achieve the objectives. Next, develops loyalty and commitment. The employees should be loyal to the company. Aisa nahi ki koi competitor unko 2000 zyada salary de raha hai to wo company chhod ke chala jaye. So that should not be the case. ऐसा नहीं कि एम्प्लॉयज एट्रीशन रेट ज्यादा है. सो एम्प्लॉयज शुड बी लॉयल टू अ स्पेसिफिक कंपनी एंड दे नीड टू बी वेरी कमिटेड. नेक्स्ट इज इंक्रीज प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड प्रॉफिट्स. वी शुड इंक्रीज द प्रोडक्टिविटी. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल वर्किंग आवर्स आर 8 आवर्स पर डे. एंटायर वीक में अगर कंपनी 6 डेज काम कर रही है, मंडे टू सैटरडे, इफ दे हैव द 8 वर्किंग आवर्स, employee should not waste the time. Effectively and efficiently they need to perform in the organization. There's a concept in HRM called HRA, human resource accounting. Under human resource accounting we are calculating the productivity, how much the company is paying to the employee, how much profit the employee is giving to the organization. Next is improve job satisfaction. The main aim of HRM department is that employees should be satisfied with the job they are performing. Why? How they give the satisfaction? How they will be the satisfied? Because if the company will think about their career planning, obviously the employee will satisfied. If companies are giving a good working environment, health and safety measures, welfare facilities, employees may be much satisfied with their job, flexible timing and other facilities. Next is enhance standard of living. Employees ka standard of living enhance karna hai. There's a concept called house rent allowances, traveling allowances, DNS allowances, the most important DNS allowances. As per the designation of the employee, the companies are giving them the higher DNS allowances. Say for example, Mr. A is a marketing manager, Mr. B is an admin department. Admin department as a clerk, he or she is working. So obviously the Mr. A will get a more allowances than the Mr. B, DNS allowances, because he needs to maintain a good standard of living as their designation. So HRM aims to enhance the standard of living as per the designation the employees are working in the organization. Next, generates employment opportunities. If there is a vacancy in the organization, the right person at the right place at during the right time, they are selecting. So it generates the employment opportunities in an efficient manner. Next, greater trust and respect. The HRM policies should be that much the employees can trust the company. The employees respect the companies, what the companies are giving them as a bread and butter in terms of salaries, in terms of recognition, in terms of the reputation the companies are giving to their employees. So these all are importance of HRM, which we, yes, in this way we have learned the characteristics and basic concepts and importance of HRM. Thank you for watching.